Good evening, and welcome to Fear Training and Fright Singing. I'm Gabe.
And I'm Mary.
Mary, do you know what solfege is?
It sounds like some type of fudge ice cream.
No. That would be nice. However, if they did make ice cream that flavor, I think musicians would be the first in line.
Well, what does it have to do with music?
Maybe this will help.
Finally got
re mi fa sol la ti. Oh, let's see if I can make it easier. Doe, a deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Far, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow so. A drink with jam and bread that will bring us back to dough. Oh, oh, oh,
no!
A deer, a female deer.
Hooray!
A drop of golden sun.
Me!
A name I call myself.
Ah!
A long, long way to run.
So,
a needle pulling thread.
La!
A note to follow so. Tea!
A drink with jam and bread.
That will bring us back to dough.
A deer, a female deer. Ray, a drop of golden sun. Me, a name I call myself. Long, a long, long way to run. So, a needle pulling thread. La, a note to follow so. Tea, a drink of jam and bread.
That will bring us back.
Hold on, I thought Rodgers and Hammerstein invented that song.
No, actually, that's not true. Let's cut to our expert out in the field to provide us with a little more insight. George? In music, solfege is a singing technique that is used to teach pitch. The technique of solfege involves studying small sequences of notes and singing the sequences in different keys. Sequences gradually get more difficult in terms of intervals and rhythms used. The seven syllables commonly used fix this practice in English sequence countries are do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, and ti or si. In other languages, si is used for the seventh scale tone, while in the earlier use in the English continues in many areas.
Okay, well yeah, that kind of clears up all the confusion. Hey, you know, I remember where I learned solfege. I've learned my do, re, mi.
And what might that be?
Okay. Do, a beer, a Mexican beer. Re, the guy behind the bar. Me, the girl I buy gear for. Far, the long way to the bar. So, I'll have another beer. Fa, la, 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 la. Tea, no thanks, I'll have a beer. That will bring us back to dough. Oh, oh, oh. Right?
Well, someone definitely ought to give that writer a high five. For creativity, yes.
Yeah.
But that is not solfege. That is not solfege at all.
You mean I was misleading people just now? Sorry.
The song was off.
Oh.
We're going to cut to the classroom to see how our students are learning the real do-re-mi.
Sorry.
As we said before, solfege is a way of learning correct pitch.
Hold on, what's pitch? Is that, you mean like what you do on the mound in baseball?
No, that's a particular tone frequency assigned to a letter named music.
Okay.
In college we learned about seven letters, A through G. But then there are also many more when you consider the sharps and flats. Those make up the in-between
right.
notes that make up the half steps in the chromatic scale.
Right. Okay, so solfege has to do with learning pitch. How? Like, why can't I just learn just using my violin? Like,
well, you could, but solfege teaches us to hear it instinctively,
oh.
so we accurately name pitches because we've got good at recognizing intervals.
Inter what?
The distance between two sounds. You remember that. Gosh, Mary, you're a violin performance major.
No.
Don't you remember anything?
Sorry, just had a viola moment. I remember now.
Fortunately, we need solfege as music majors.
That's right. Fear training and fright singing. Somehow my parents made it through, so I know there's hope.
Do you guys remember the first day of Aural Skills with Dr. Babel?
Yeah.
Welcome to Aural Skills 1. Instead of using your ears for hearing, they will now be for seeing. And instead of using your eyes to see, they will now be hearing.
What?
Do, re, mi, fa, sol, la, ti, do. As you practice this in the piano room.
Do not use the piano.
Was my only hope.
Do, mi.
Because your ear was already used to hearing the distance. The thing about solfege is that do, re, mi, and so on give you a way to hear those intervals without needing the piano. I hate to say it, but you're being kind of lazy.
At least you started class practicing the right exercises.
Exercises. For the first week, we'll do the first eight.
She said to do the first eight exercises. Only one page? She must have meant 8 pages. We're learning minor our first week of class. I don't even know how to sing not minor right now.
Learning all those exercises so fast must have been like going from...
Oh, oh, no! A deer, a female deer.
Ray!
A drop of golden sun.
Me!
A name I call my... Oh, let's see if I can make it easier.
Yeah, I've gradually learned to make it easier for myself. How?
How?
Well, first I look at the key signature. Then I sing my triad and skim the exercise for hard spots that are in the song, like interval jumps, strange rhythms, that kind of stuff. Like this.
Okay. F major. Gonna take it down to C. Do, mi, so, mi, do. Do, re, mi, fa, so, fa, mi, re, mi.
So it's never hard for you, huh?
Oh, sure, it can be. But I just know that if I spend quality time rather than quantity time in the practice room practicing well, I'll actually learn something that will stay with me. Plus, I'll pass the class with flying colors.
So we've discovered that sightseeing can be difficult.
But when we consider how it will help us in our future careers as musicians, it makes all the difference.
As a music educator, I'll use solfege all the time. Like when the classroom is having difficulties learning a piece, I can use solfege to teach them the piece.
As a violin performance major, my goal is to be an awesome violin teacher. In my own playing, solfege has already helped me to learn to hear whole and half steps so I can play and start identifying them when I set my fingers on the violin. The music that I'm playing, it's also helped me too. If I can understand pitch this way, just think what I could do in teaching my students.
Since solfege is singing, it's directly related to my field of music. I can see it helping me in vocal performance.
Solfege is really sight singing and ear training, even though it may feel like fright singing and fear training. Just remember that it's worth it if you love music.
Thank you, students, for your valuable insight.
So now we're going to go to Sherry, our correspondent, to learn a little bit more about the history of solfege. Take it away, Sherry. Solfege is usually taught during several years of undergraduate university musical study. The goals are to train singers in sight reading and sight singing, to give them more precise pitch, to improve recognition of musical intervals, perfect fifths, minor sixths, etc., and to strengthen their understanding of musical theory. Thank you, Sherry.
Mary, this just in. In the 11th century, the music theorist Guido of Arezzo developed a six-note ascending scale that went as follows. Ut, re, mi, fa, sol, and la. A seventh note, C, was added shortly after. The names were taken from the first verse of the Latin hymn Ut quant laxis, where the syllables fall on their corresponding scale degree.
Wow. It's very interesting.
That is very exciting news.
It is. From the 11th century.
The 11th century.
Wow.
This is breaking. Wow. My goodness. Good evening. I'm your host, Gabe.
And I'm Mary. And we've been learning about fear training and fright singing. And now we want to tell you, have no fear. What, seventh chord today? Wasn't that just
that seventh chord? My goodness. I don't even know.
I mean, it's just like pretty cool that we understand it now, you know?
Yeah.
What's the mod 12 for that again?
Cut. So I'm not married.
We have a fill-in tonight.
Awkward.
If they did make ice cream that flavor.
Cut.
Oh my gosh, this is weird.
No. That would be nice. However, if they do make ice cream matte flavor, musicians would be first in line.
Does it have to steal me?
This is weird. You look so...
Yeah, that did take long.
We can't both do that.
That's what we're gonna do the entire time. We're just gonna... Good evening. Good evening.
Okay.
This is fear training.
And fright singing. Well,
are you gonna take the second part?
Yeah. Well,
spread on field. I don't know what I'm saying. We have blah blah blah. No, actually, that is not true. We're gonna cut to our colleague. I still don't know what I'm saying. No. Okay, let's practice it.